hundreds. It's the coach. You're watching Madden Football on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see teams with a couple of running backs who each went over 100 yards a week.
All right, Coach, we welcome everybody to the Garden State. EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Today, it's week four. We've got what should be a great one here between the Denver Broncos and the New York Giants.
Skill set is absolutely fantastic. There's not anything that he can't do as a quarterback on the field. But I also think that he absorbed a little bit by osmosis. Some of that great bloodline. His father, formerly a quarterback in the NFL as well.
This is Saquon Barkley. And officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
Anytime you throw an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12.
And watch that. And watch the ball.
It's Barkley on the catch. The second down play not much better than the first. Just a gain of one. The offense, if we give you too much power here, we let you highlight the player. Why'd you choose Zeitler?
Because I think the big guys up front never get enough credit. Kevin Zeitler, a guard, tough, nasty. We've got to give him some love.
So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive. Just an account for him.
But what you hope is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
35 yards on the return. Picked up some good blocks as well. It'll be a short field for the Broncos as they take over first and 10.
As you want him to play if you're a coach. Three touchdown passes, zero interceptions, which usually means you're making a lot of right decisions out there. Challenge, they are certainly getting one in this ball game because they are facing the number one rush. rushing unit in the NFL, which means there's going to be a contest they've got to be prepared for on the first snap.
Leave him! Leave him!
He'll try to run forward and runs it. And he'll be close to a first down as he runs into the wall. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I can imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of the game. So, second and 10 from the 25. Throwing is long. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't draw many defensively. The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as a 32. The completion good for the 6-7.
Well, the good thing about covering any game I do with you is I know there is no problem with rhythm. Now, when you're watching offensively, a little bit of a problem there.
Yeah, punt on the first drive, looking at another one here. Just a little slow. You know, they're talking about a fast start, but that hasn't been the case.
Yeah, I'm just facing it. Any team we talk about always talks about a fast start. That's true. It's not necessarily going to happen just because they say so. And whether it's the script, whether it's, you know, just what they're going through, whether it's in different defenses, they have to figure it out as this game goes on.
And they'll get him down and pass the 14 just shy of the 20. Broncos first down there, 12 yards on the play.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the defensive line. They just cash him in. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. football as we begin quarter number two. As they've got everything second down coming up. Broncos football as we begin quarter number two. As they got everything second down coming up. Throwing out second and long. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the line. Third down. Incomplete pass on that last play. That means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines.
That was awfully close, but in the end, he says it passed over the 1 yard line, and that's where they're going to mark it out. I mean, you can see it right there, right? See it walking up the sideline? Told him to stop right there at the one.
And New York set to take the field. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get the shot on goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not just about a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory. And you're going to see the downside to use it as a run down because sometimes you get on your game. You're going to pick the run quite as well because you're headed towards the back corner with abandon.
It's a game of the run and the giant first down. Thanks for that last play. A little more room to operate. First and 10 at the 18. Now Saquon Barkley. Given 4 yards there, he'll be second at 6.
If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using 5 defensive backs, 6 defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
On here, Brandon McManus for the point after. It's up and good, and they increase their lead to 10-0. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but they're returning it to the end zone for the pick six. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And what now? He gears up to lead this offense again. He's got to dig deep here, doesn't he? Team's losing. He's not playing well either.
Tell you don't press, you'll make things a little bit worse. But in this particular situation, you try and heighten your play a little bit. So far, he's done one interception. He wants to bounce that off at least one touchdown pass in order to get his team back.
Let's go, it's a giant first down and a gain of 16. One play has him up past the 40 already. First and 10. Here's one. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second and down. And now it's second and 10 again for the 41.
Mike, 34. Let's go, heavy. Let's go, heavy. Everyone's
Incomplete. The position of yours is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was out of the difference. That's what brings the conversion. It's complete to go and take. They're able to convert on third down. That sets up the first and goal.
significant number.
Going on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Throwing the football is not as sharp as he was last week, but he was over 70% right now. He's under 50%.
Team, not just the points on the board, but the momentum and taking it from coast to coast, end zone to end zone. What a tremendous play. Now get that man an oxygen tent.
That's your boy Old Mo, you said momentum, right?
Old Mo, I think he's kind of limping across at the end because of that distance, but he made it.
Now McManus to tack on the extra point. He's got it, and it's 17-0. Seconds to go in the first half. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. This is taken at the 23. It's a 39-yard line. And the Broncos take over first down and 10. The Broncos offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. You've got under a minute to go here until halftime. You got the good size lead. No need to do anything crazy.
Seconds to go in this first half.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Rock now on first down.
Chiefs go there, just creating a disaster there for the offense. He's now going to go 16 yards in the wrong direction.
94. Get ready.
A final shot before half. And his throw here is incomplete. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Brandon, we'll get back to you guys in a bit, but first let's take a look around the NFL here on this first Sunday of October. We'll start over at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, and in the second quarter it is the Eagles who are out in front. Josh Reynolds, 2 touchdown catches on the afternoon. Next we head off to check out another game, and they've got the lead over the visiting Arizona Cardinals. Dak Prescott lighting it up. He's got 3 touchdown passes. Finally, let's get down to Houston. Check on the Texans at home at NRG Stadium. And they trail in that ball game to the visiting Seattle Seahawks. Josh Gordon, a touchdown reception. In the game you're watching, it's been Drew Lock with a strong first half. His guys have the lead as we'll hand it back over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Broncos with a lead, and they will be receiving this kickoff here as quarter 3 is underway. This one taken just inside the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
They're on a 3-game winning streak, and right now looking good in this one as well. Step. Second half starts with a run by Lindsey. He's able to get this down deep on the Giants side of the field.
Let's go!
It's a big play there for the Broncos. 51 yards on the ground. So the field flips here as they'll go to work at it.
Will not be returned. Let's go for it. Three. Zone for a touchback.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And their halftime hole now even deeper, and they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown in the second half score against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger, but no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the board and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
Quick throw. Here's Shepard. As they come up on third down. The shot is snapped away. And this is going to be incomplete. What a difference a week makes. Last week he hit on over 80% of his passes. This week he's down under 50%. What do you see as the difference?
Yeah, I think we're used to seeing a drop. If someone's over 80%, they're not going to hold that number. Not in this league. Dropped under 50%. That just tells me that the defense is putting extra time on game films and came up with a really good plan to try and chip away this time.
Ready. It's a Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. And they're hoping to redo the last drive when they got to the end zone.
Just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tackle and see what you did on the last drive. When you score the points, it's a whole lot of view out there when you're trying to figure out how to do
it. Another mistake here defensively as a flag is down on the tackle, and that's going to tackle on 15. The official so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took it out of their hands, having to wonder whether it's 15-yard is right or not. It's a lot easier if you see it, you call it.
A nice burst there as he'll get about 7 on top of the first down. Come again. 7 yards on the pickup. Third, it'll leave him with a second and three. A good run. Got 7 on first. 2 second and three. Now it's Lindsay. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. A gain of 5. Good enough for the first down.
55.
Well run. It's Lindsay. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It looks like we've got a Broncos that's banged up on the play. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium.
Here we go! 70, Indy!
And up! On second and 12. He's got his big tight end, Fan. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. 15 yards on the play, first down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it. Sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
Officially, no gain on the play. And that's second down.
Check that, check that.
Receiver, maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There are your results in a touchdown. McManus's point after is good, and that will extend this big lead. To the touchdown. Here's McManus now to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives.
Baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit, he's on base, it brings Jack in.
possession went just shy of the end. This is back. And second down plays went in the wrong direction. Here's incomplete. He had his hands on it, but couldn't pick it. It's now fourth down. Here's Sam Cook now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. This is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. The drive will commence with a run by Lindsey. A gain of 3 seconds.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep the ball going. They want to put the onus on the big fellas up front.
Set up an interesting third and about four to go.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight up. End of game. Just keep that clock ticking.
Broncos on third down. 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 4.
Five.
From the gun on third down. And he hits his target. Hamilton. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
Let's go.
They've been going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down.
60 out
now. Just 8 of 16 thus far. 50% for the first and 10. Shotgun snap and again to Lindsey. And they will only muster a yard here on the 38.
Well, Carter, number one stats guy just handed me a little card that says he has 97 yards on the ground today. You think he's going to win again?
I think so. Three away from that century mark. Got to have it.
Yeah, but he's really going to call. His wife is 100 pounds. Whatever he feels comfortable with.
Give him 14 yards here to Denver first down.
First down.
So takes him in the Giants territory now. First and 10 at the 48-yard line. Jim Hamilton to pick up the ball in the second down.
Well, we now know this type of running back.
Go now.
I mean, this size, this intensity, usually gets better as the game goes on.
Yeah.
I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters,
he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. First and goal after a gain of 19. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball.
And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Starting to really smell a 4-0 start right now.
Can't ask for a better first quarter of the season than that.
And you're not supposed to look ahead, but guess what? They have to, because when you get to four, if you get to 4-0, you're not just thinking playoffs now. You're thinking about, okay, this team has the capabilities of winning a Super Bowl. They could very well be the best team in the NFL at this moment.
I think they played the best. I mean, there have been a few hiccups offensively and defensively, but probably the best team we've seen, right?
And has the ability to get better.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This is taken at his four. Taking that pass to 25 to the 26-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And I'm being facetious here, but you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself.
I'm going to get you all the time. Stay right now.
Suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. This one fielded at the five. Take this across the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
They are just obviously getting shellacked here on this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach? For the drive and a lopsided
first down.
Let's go. Hey, well, Mike 34. Mike
34. Finds his tight end Ingram. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line.
I know you feel
one thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been good.
And because of that, it's been very, very important to move the ball, because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. The tackling almost on the spot. That means after running extra plays, I'm harder to move the ball.
2 yards on the carry. That's going to lead him to third down. From the game, and he walks it past the 30, almost to the 25. He'll get 15 and the Giants first down. It's Wilson. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of four. So this one will bring up a Denver victory. I'll tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one, and that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory.
So for Denver, that early momentum continues here as they move to 4-0, and they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Giants, they'll fall back to 500 at 2-2, and they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.